Hey everyone, it's Brandon Laganda here, and today I'm going to show you how to create a custom Rick and Morty intro from scratch and completely free. For this tutorial, we're going to be using a program called Hitfilm Express, which is a free video effects compositor and editor. So go ahead and grab your free copy from the FX Home website, and let's get started. Once you open up your project, create a comp and name it title. Now create a text layer by clicking on the text tool and drawing a box in the center of the screen. In the text panel, set the font to Get Thrifty. Set the font color to a bright blue and the stroke color to a dark green. And the stroke width to 2. Then just type in your title. Once you're done, duplicate the text layer. For the bottom text, set the stroke color to a bright light green and the stroke width to 5.3. In the effects menu, add a drop shadow effect to the bottom text. And set the color to be a very bright green. Set the distance to 0, opacity to 1, and penumbra to 23 pixels. Now we're going to create the lightnings that strike the text at the beginning of the intro. For that, create a black plane and name it Lightning Strike. Then right-click it and set the blend mode to Add. And make sure the plane is at the very top of the composition. In the effects menu, search for lightning and electricity and drag it over to the plane. In the properties menu, set trunks to 2, wave scale to 0.25, and twitch scale to 0.7. Now move the start and end points to the top left corner of the screen, but make them out of frame. Now move the cursor to the beginning. Add a keyframe for the end point by clicking on a circle right next to its name. And do the same thing for the growth property of the start point. Move forward a few frames, and move the end point down, making it touch the text. And keyframe the growth property of the start point to be 0 in the beginning and 1 a few frames after the lightning hits the text. Now we need multiple lightnings like this. So duplicate the plane by right clicking it and selecting duplicate, or by just pressing Ctrl D or Command D if you're on a Mac. Now move the start and end points to a new position. But do the same animation you just did with the first one. Just don't forget to change the seed property so the lightning doesn't look exactly the same. Do this 2 more times and you're done. Now select the 4 lightning layers you have, right click, make composite shot, and name it whatever you like. When you come back to your main comp, don't forget to set the blend mode of the comp you just created to Add. Select the first text layer again, and add a mask that covers the entire text. In this case, we only need a square mask. Click this button right next to the viewport, and draw your mask. In the mask properties dropdown, click this button to invert the mask. So now it only shows what's outside the mask. In the mask transform properties, find the scale property. Now click the chain icon to unlink the scale values, so one doesn't affect the other. Keyframe the mask's X scale to be 0 after the lightnings hit the text, and 100 at the beginning, so it looks like the text is being generated by the lightnings. Copy this mask and paste it on the second text layer. Now we're going to create the little lightnings that come out of the text. Create another plane and name it Lightning Shock. And set its blend mode to add. Add another lightning and electricity effect. But this time, set the wave scale to 0.3 and the twitch scale to 0.7. In the branches dropdown, set the branches to 0. In the animation dropdown, set all the values to 2. Move the start point to the top of one of the ladders and the end point slightly above it. Now add keyframes for the end point. Move forward a second and move the end point to where the start point is. Now duplicate the plane and move the lightning to a new position. Again, don't forget to change the seed. Now do this multiple times and you will have a lot of lightnings coming out of your text. For my intro, I used about 11 lightning layers, but for the sake of this tutorial, I'm only going to use 7. Now select all the lightning layers you created, right click them, and make composite shot. And do the same thing you did with the other lightning comp. Go back to your main comp and set the blend mode to add. Add a glow effect to the upper text layer. Lower its threshold and radius. And increase the per channel intensity for the blue channel. Keyframe the intensity to be 1 at the beginning of the shot, and 0 after the lightnings of the text disappear. So it looks like this. We're almost done. We only need one final touch, and that is the lightning that goes through the text at the end. Create a black plane and name it Lightning Text. Add another lightning and electricity effect, then set the blend mode to add. And add keyframes for the start and end points. Now, move the start point to the top of the first letter of the text and the end to the bottom of that same letter. Then move one frame forward and move the lightning to the right following the path of the letters. And do this frame by frame until you reach the end of the text. Don't forget to change the seed. And you've got yourself a custom Rick and Morty intro. If you really want to make it look like the original intro, you can add yet another text layer, change the font to Rick and Morty, and make it white. And there you have it! So, I hope this tutorial helped you. If it did, please don't forget to subscribe and drop a like. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.